Hello, it's me. I know it's a bit difficult to be working on cool, new, and exciting things while we're all stuck at home, but if you have a functioning computer, we can prepare our files for printing so they're ready by the time we're back on campus. So I'm going to show you guys how to prepare your very own stickers, and we're going to be doing this on Illustrator. If you don't have Illustrator, then this is awkward. Don't worry, if the campus hasn't offered you some sort of license to use from home, Adobe offers free trials for new time users. I think it lasts like 30 days or something like that. Okay, so we're here. Start by opening a document that's 18 inches by 18 inches. If you haven't already met our fancy schmancy printer, Benny, the rolls of sticker vinyl that we use in it have 18 inches of width to print on. So this document will be perfect size for Benny. The document should look like this so far. If your tools look different, go up here and change your layout to Essentials Classic. Now you might have different ideas of what you want your sticker to be. The main thing that we're concerned about is how it transfers to Illustrator. Most likely your design is a raster image file, meaning it's built from pixels. Illustrator is a vector-based program, so we're either changing your image to a vector or working around it. I'll talk about it as I go. So place your design into the canvas with file place and then click it in. All right, there we go. Now we have art. Even if we'd saved it just like this, the printer will be able to print this out. The thing that we want to worry about though is the cut line. This is where it gets tricky, so focus. We're going to go up here to your swatches and it should look like this. We're going to be adding a new swatch. Make sure that you have this little box right here selected over instead of the question mark box. Make sure you don't have that your image selected when you're doing this, so click off of it and it should look like that. And click on any of these random colors to apply a stroke so that way we are able to add a new one. And here we go. So go up here to the swatch name and you're gonna name it Cut Contour. This is important, make sure it's case sensitive. And change the color type to spot color. Any printer reads through two kinds of colors, process and spot colors. Process colors are the colors included in the printed image, and spot colors are just the instructions for the printer to follow. So when it sees spot color, it's gonna go to the swatch name and go, "Oh, I should cut that." Once you have that done, just make it a perfect magenta. It's easier to spot it that way, huh? Okay. Now we have our spot color assigned, right here. So now we're going to outline the image depending on how it's shaped. For this one, it's just a box. So we're just going to make a little box around it. So go up here to the rectangle shape tool, and then outline your box. And if it looks like this, it's okay, don't panic. It just made a rectangle, and over here are the colors of this rectangle. You'll notice that the outline is that magenta that we just used, and the fill is white. So the way we get rid of this fill is we make it transparent. Bam, look at that. And if your stroke isn't initially the swatch that we made, just go over here, make sure it's selected, and then click on the swatch. And now it's that swatch. Now because the knife of the printer may be pretty precise, there's a pretty big line for it to cut out. It's like when you try to cut something out with scissors, millimeters at a time, to get it just right. That's what it'll do to this line. So go up here, make sure it's selected, then go up here, and make the stroke weight very, very small. You can do 0.01, so just do that. At this point, you can adjust the cut line and where you want it to be. If you wanted it to have some kind of margin space before it hits the image, you can do that. Whatever suits your fancy. And then you can group it all together by selecting everything and then hitting Control G. Or right click and say group, that's fine too. Now you can resize your sticker. If you want a 3-inch sticker, boom, just make sure that this thing is locked. Because if it's not locked and you do something like this, that's a no-no. Then you can place your image right here at the bottom. Don't put it over, please. Then you can tile your stickers out with copy and paste. Or if you want your life to be 10 times easier, make sure that your sticker is selected and then hold Alt. You see this cursor? That means that it's gonna double it. Drag it out to wherever you want it to be. The guides will help you. And then let go. Look at that. And if you want to avoid doing this 78 more times, you can just hit Control D so it can duplicate the action. This is how I usually tile all my stickers and it's really fun. You should try it sometime. Well, this document is now ready for print. Just save it as an EPS file to your flash drive and we'll be able to print it when you come
in.
Wait,
I have a design that I want to cut out on the stickers, but I want the cut to be around the design, not in a box.
Okay, we can do that too. Create a new file, 18 by 18, and place your stickers in there, and immediately make that contour swatch. So right here I have a raster image file, and then I have a vector file. You'll notice the difference is that there's an X over this one. If your file is a vector, then this will be really easy. We're just going to be using a few different tools. So move your image to the side. Open the layers panel so that you can see what's going on while we do this, and open this sublayer so you know where everything is. Go ahead and select your vector. copy it, and then press Control B. This will paste it in place below the original layer, so now we have an exact copy. Either lock or hide that top layer, because we're not going to use it. We're going to be using this bottom layer to mess with. Select that bottom layer, go to Window, go to Pathfinder, and now you have this little window. Click this option. This basically takes all the shapes within your vector and compresses it down into one giant silhouette. And if you see little cuts inside of your silhouette, you can always go to the Direct Select tool and then click on an anchor point and backspace it out. So far we have this. Go back to the selection tool and select everything. So go back to the colors that are being used and then press this little arrow right here. And it should swap everything that was in a fill for a stroke and a stroke for a fill, so now we should have an outline of everything. Now we can go back to swatches, apply the cut contour, and then bring back the layer that you locked earlier, and boom, look at that, now you have a cut line around this object. Remember to change that stroke weight to 0.01 and then group everything together. To add a little white margin around this is going to be a little more tricky. Take that outline that you just made, increase the stroke by a lot, up to the point where you want the white outline. That looks good.
You can get rid of these jagged little shapes if you go to the stroke settings and change it to a rounded cap.
Take the magenta that you just increased, go up here to Object, and go to Expand. For all of those options, just say OK, and then pathfind it all together into one silhouette again. Go to the Direct Selection tool, take out anything in the center, and then take the giant shape that you just made, turn that into an outline. Look at that! 0.01, group it all, and you're done. And you can start tiling. Now if this is an image you want to cut around, this is going to be a little more tricky. Go ahead and copy and paste below and hide the original. Now go to Window, Image Trace, and now you'll have this window. This little friend of ours is going to change our image into a vector file by guesswork. When you have your image selected, it'll give you all these fancy options. Change that black and white option to color, and then make it the max amount of colors that it will let you, which is 30. Now hit preview, and if it says to do anything like this to rasterize the object, just say okay, and watch it work its magic. Wow. Okay, there it is. Of course, you can always play around with these advanced settings if it looks a little too lumpy and you want to be more smooth, but we're mostly focused on the shape and how exact it is. Once we are okay with our life choices, we can go up here and hit expand. Now we have a bunch of shapes. At this point, we can go up here to the Direct Selection tool and then start deleting all those shapes that we don't want in the background by selecting it, double backspacing it, and leaving our beautiful subject in the center. Now take the shape that you want to make and pathfind it all together. If there are these little spots that didn't quite make the silhouette, you can always go into the Direct Selection tool and click them out, but it may be faster to use the Lasso tool right underneath it and just select them in bulk. And from this point, you can kind of guess where I'm going to go with this. Select it all, flip it to an outline, adjust the size if you want to add that margin space, and I kind of do. Go to Object, Expand, say OK, and pathfind it once again. Take out that center, and then flip that outline once more. Bring back your image, and you'll notice that it's underneath the image, so go ahead and go to your layers. Drag this layer on top of the image so that you can see it. Oh, I kind of left white space at the bottom. It's fine. Take your outline, apply that swatch, and change it to 0.01. Take everything, group it together, resize for tiling. And don't worry about all this extra stuff in the image and how I'm overlapping it. It's only going to cut where you put that cut line. So everything else in the image isn't going to be included by the time you take it off the sticker. If you want the rest of the image to not be there, ungroup it, copy and paste below your cut line, make that cut line a clipping mask with your image. And then group the second cut line with your cut image. I don't do this in case the printer accidentally offsets the cut, and then you'll have a white line going downside and it does not look pretty. Alright, so once you have your stickers that ready to print, all you have to do is go to the artboard tool and resize the canvas just for the height so that way we don't waste that much sticker vinyl. Now you're going to be saving this as an EPS file, solely because it is Betty's favorite. There's also a lot of other reasons, so don't take that seriously. And you are now ready to go when you need to print stickers in the space. A very similar process is used for the t-shirts, but we'll probably talk about that soon too. Thanks for sticking around with me. Okay, bye.